So, before I get into today's episode, my recorder has changed a lot. It's apparently a beta. It was never a beta before. This all shouldn't exist if everything's right here. Why have this if it's all right here? I don't have mouse on, so you guys have no idea what I'm doing. Actually, you do, because of highlights. But whatever. It's rather bizarre. Anyways, hey, what is going on, everybody? I am back today with another video, and I am the Sage. And the Sharingan. And a stand user. Oh, yeah. Bug. Well, not a bug, actually. I kind of died, actually. There you go. There we go. And... so, funny story. I actually died doing some tests and off-camera work and all that, like, because I was testing one of the abilities I unlocked. I did a bunch of grinding. Like, I mean, a bunch of grinding. I am at level 433. That's how much grinding I've been doing. And, yeah. So, if I take a quick look at my backpack, I did unlock some stuff. This is broken now. Body replacement technique. It's, a little broken. I will show you why shortly. I was testing... out... dual death technique. It hurts me, and I was stupidly testing it on a vampire. And body replacement technique, I got it, but the glitch is the fact that, well, if I do this, make my heart arrow first, well, not stand arrow, and get some juice point scrolls, because this is busted. How many do I need? Oh, I already have 25 points. Oh, you require 30. So 25 you require. Yeah. So just get. There is no five. So get 5 ones. So, yeah, here's the thing about it. The durability means there's more to be given. So, if I quickly get it, which I already have it, it stays there. Instead of doing what the Sharingan does, well, the Magekino Sharingan skill learner does, not available yet. The Snake skill learner just constantly gives you new and new body replacement techniques. And it eats away at your points anyways. So, that was garbage. Yeah. Also, I cheated in a new item because it's not available at all in this version. Not even in the newest version. I got this. Summon Mandada. Manda? Summon Manda. You know, that snake I... That snake I fought. But I can't use it because it costs 400 chakra. Right-click to mount. While mounted, V for fireball, C for ground dig. Neither of those buttons work because they're not meant to be available yet. Plus, C just conflicts with this. So, I don't know why that default button's C if it's required for them. But, enough about all this. I currently have 80 Kinjutsu and 300 Medical. Yes, I have reached 300 Medical Jutsu. Let's clean up my inventory. Oh my god, my armor is thrashed. First, new stand. I'm fine with Silver Chariot. Quick Attacker gives me haste 3 and does not break blocks. Alright, so my new stand is Silver Chariot. But now, for the main event that some of you have been waiting for. It's time to become the Kurama! Become the Ninetales Jinjutsuki. Now, I cannot turn into it yet, but if I get the... Skill Learner, I kind of require this. Because it's meant to act as a timer. What the heck? Alright, so I need to keep around 20 points. 20 jutsu points. So, I need to earn 20 more jutsu points. This is how it works every time. You were a timer before. Like, this right here is useless. It just tells you how to get everything and what you need in order to get everything. But, there's something about it that I do want to show you guys. I have too much health for you freaks now. Seriously, I'm at 17. I don't know how much 17 rows is. Can someone do that math for me? You know, 17 rows, but one of the rows of 10 heart. Like, it's 20 hearts per row, but for the 17th row, I have 2 health. Can someone help me with that math? I already have an Earth scroll right there. Bye. Now, real quick to show you guys something. I need some electric fence, which is white fence and iron and a redstone torch. So the white fence is bone meal and a fence. Bone, wood, bone meal. Sticks. Fence. fence. Toss out. Is it nighttime? It is not. I don't know where their vampires are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One redstone. And a stick. Oh yeah, they can attack through doors. For those of you who did not know that. Now, let me be able to show off the thing. I will do this in... Ooh, money. Thank you for that money. Can you stop that? Something I will show you guys. Oh, it's you. What do you have? What do you have? You have that. I don't want rolling log. Rolling log is good, but it's also stupid. Now, watch this. Okay, now I just need to lose the rest from loss of hunger. And then I'll be able to show you what the thing is. Though, thinking about it, I don't think it's going to work because of my Sharingan lifesaver thing. Who knows? Hunger is not a thing in this version, by the way. Like, the hunger effect. But poison is. Don't. those things can also kill you. Oh yeah, also, I found... See? I also found these off camera. They're condensed essence berry bushes. He was gonna die anyway. I was just gonna end his suffer. Ow! Dang it! Ooh, a cake. Oh, that wasn't a common bag. That was a cake bag. Anyways. These things, if they're fully grown and have the berries around them, you can right-click them, get these, and these give you experience. Not much experience, mind you. But in fairness, I am literally at 105 levels. Speaking of 105 levels, Right, this is why I was collecting books. Ah, there we go. Don't die on me, kid. I'll grant you some of my power for this once. Kurama actually talks to me when I am near death and gives me buffs. Speed 2, Strength 2, Jump Boost 2, Resistance 2. The fire resistance, I believe he gives me that, because he's fire resistant. I'm not sure. But when you're near death, he will actually talk to you. My armor's dead. Dang nabbits. Yeah, go figure. I'll enchant you later. Yeah. See, he also gives you nausea for a few seconds. Because, you know, you're upsetting him. And he's stealing your body. So yeah, there was meant to be a timer when you, like, quote-unquote, obtain the skill learner to tell you how long it takes until he will use your 20 jutsu points to give you the Baijinyu cloak. So, let's do some training and try to get to 20 jutsu points. Actually, thinking about that, JP. 150. 1 and 10. Yeah. Yeah, just realizing. 20 jutsu points. I know you guys are gonna say I'm a cheater for doing that, but I had 25. But then I had to demonstrate a bug. So, if anything, I was getting my 20 back. So, don't call me a cheater for that one, guys. Now, just so you guys know, in case I forgot to mention it, I feel like I said it, but at the same time, I feel like I didn't. This thing is useless. It has no purpose other than when you're cheated in, it tells you how many jutsu points you need in order to get the thing. Can you just right click it when like? It's timer. There's a timer for the tailed beast. Can I get it? One of these is meant to show a timer. What is that? Defeated Zabuza. Okay. Seriously, one of these had a timer. I'm not kidding. Also, this chest here is for dumping my inventory. For you now. Loot bags. Yeah. I'll get the one from my house later. Those are going to be necessary, by the way, because when the timer is up on, you know, on Kurama giving you your first thing, you got to get nearly dead, and then he will give you the thing. Alright, so this is where the lag will really start. Because these slime grinders are boring and laggy, but they are useful. I really gotta remember to turn this thing off when I do this. Now, come down here. Throw away this stupid axe. Aw, oh, too hungry for the attack. Yeah, this is an amazing attack. It eats up a lot of your hunger, but it's really great. I really need to set up a hopper system, by the way, just, you know, have chests underneath here and then get a hopper. Yeah. Just to collect. Jutsu points you should keep around 20. Don't you guys just love how this was a castle at first and then I turned it into my own slime grinder? Level up, by the way, I'm gonna do a little something something. One more kill. Yep, and there we go. So first something something I'm gonna do is all my loot bags. Dump out all the slime. Grab the next one. Use some obsidian. That's all junk to me. Money. Junk. Coal, I'll take. The rest is junk. Corpse. And okay, so while this slime grinder runs, oh, there's a king slime down there. Nah, whatever. Okay, there we go. And there he is. Perfect. Honestly, stands. One of the best ways to drain your hunger. Just use their ultimate attack. Because it uses hunger. Something I need to check, actually. Do I still... I don't. It's... Oh, I know. Yes, I do. It's these I was worried about. Be back. This one was Soto. This one was Geppo. Actually, no, this one was Soto, and this was Geppo. There we go. Got that setup back. Don't die on me now. Don't die on me, kid. I'll grant you some of my power for this once. And he's just gonna repeat that every single time as long as I am very low. Health. Ow, ow, ow. And the senses change depending on, you know, how much, depending on what stage you're at on everything. So, the timer is a while, but hopefully I can manage to exceed said timer. Slash game. Rule. Data cycle. False. Slash time set. 8,000. Slash time set. 1,000. And B. Okay, there it goes. Why isn't my shooting gun doing the same thing? Oh, this is draining very quickly, so that means that timer is... the timer is now going exponentially fast. Oh yeah, I need to... Man, I wish the timer would actually show on this dang thing. Yeah, but yeah, it's useless. I'm right-clicking right now and left-clicking, doing everything. There's no point in the skill learner except for telling you how many points you need to keep for when you unlock something. Like, a different stage of the things. There's no way to obtain it legitimately, by the way. What do I put in my thing now? Put more in Senjutsu, because I could do more Senjutsu. Because of Shift N. Okay, so here's where I'm at a standstill. There we go. Time is still going super fast. Awesome. So hopefully soon, instead of, you know, the 9 hours it's meant to be, I believe it was 9 hours, Long time, main point. Instead of it taking a long, long time, it will now take almost no time. Oh. Actually, it'll still take quite a bit of time. But it won't take as long for me to unlock the Tailed Beast Cloak. Or the Vaijinyu Cloak. I don't know its actual pronunciation, but I pronounce it anyway. Can you burn? Why are you just wood? Well, stone, I didn't realize that. You were meant to be special. Right. I don't know if you guys can hear me, by the way. This is actually getting kind of annoying for me, so I am going to turn you down to a measly 30. Never thought I'd ever have to turn that volume down. But I have turned down my volume. I will grant you some of my power for this once. Yeah, right. You're giving me a lot of power just for it to be just for once. Yeah, look at all the buffs he gives you. Holy cow. Strength 2, jump boost 2, regeneration, resistance. Just for nearly dying. That was a risk I just took. Now, I know the nausea is probably upsetting a lot of you. Trust me, it's upsetting me as well. If I could stop all the nausea, I would. But this, I can get straight up votes from here. I'm just gonna take this instead of paper. So, this is a very nauseating episode, and I'm sorry about that. But hey, that's the price we all gotta pay for me becoming a Kurama. Also known as a tail beast. Books. Yeah, a part of my mind was saying, you need books. You need books. But my body was saying, why? But then today I remembered why. Yeah, world mystery. Those are very rare. Alright, intelligence is 64. 67! I got a lucky 3. And, yep. Okay, guys, so I know this episode's kind of boring with a bunch of grinding and all that, but it is getting a bit long, and I don't think I'm going to be unlocking my Tail Beast power in this episode, but just like I was doing with the Sharingan, I will have some stuff ready for each stage unlocking. So, be prepared for that, guys. The next few videos are not going to be Naruto Madness, but it's going to be Tail Beast Mode Staging. Unlocking, whatever. Like I have been doing. I'm gonna eat now. Just so I can stop getting nauseous. For a bit. But yeah, guys. I'm gonna be ending this episode here. I hope you all have a wonderful day. I will see you all next time, and goodbye.